Hey everyone, welcome back to the Writing Reproducible Papers in R tutorial video series. I've lost track of what number we're on. This is my third one in a row. So we've done t-tests, we've done ANOVAs, we've done linear regression or linear models. So it's really the tip of the iceberg in terms of statistics and R. Every project's going to have its own way of analyzing the data. So you'll really have to do your own homework in figuring out which test is best for you, how to run that test in R, but have full faith in knowing that it can be run in R. So I want to talk about the outputs a little more that we got from our previous tests. So from t-tests, from ANOVA, from regression. The cool thing about R is that instead of just getting that output, you can actually interact with that output and use it in your text, which is going to be an extremely powerful tool when we go to write our papers to be fully reproducible. We don't want to have to look at this output table and say, okay, the degrees of freedom were 147, now go over here and type 147. We want to take it directly from the output file, from the output summary, and take the number and move it into the text without us actually typing it. That's going to be one of the huge, huge benefits of doing this whole process of writing this paper in R. So I'm here looking at our linear models that we got from our last video. We did tidy first LM, we did glance first LM, and we did summary first LM. So let's look at these a little more, right? So we have tidy first LM and we had this output. So we had seen this in the previous video. And now what we want to do is say, okay, what is actually in first LM? Now we can use the names function. The first thing we can do is give tidy first LM an object. So let's call this output. I practiced this too. I can't believe I already messed up. So output is tidy first LM. And now what we can do is we can look at output, which is over here. So now we have a data frame of our statistical test output, and we have columns, term, estimate, standard error, statistic, p-value, and we have one for each predictor, right? So what we can do is do names output, and we can see what the names of each column of that output is: term, estimate, standard error, statistic, p-value. Okay, the next thing we can do is say, I want a specific part of that output. So say I want to know what the p-value was for species virginica. It's this extremely small number, right? So it's the third row in this data frame. So what we're going to do is we're going to do output dollar sign. Remember, the dollar sign is giving you this specific column in that data frame, and you can see it already pops out of all the names that we have, right? Term, estimate, standard error, so on and so on. I want the p-value, and I want the third one. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open a bracket, a square bracket, and type in 3. Now when I hit that, I get 2.62 to the 10th of negative 76. And if we look, that's this number. So I've now pulled out that specific number from my output. Awesome. Now what I could do is I could give this an assignment. I could give this an object. And I could call this Virginica p-value, right? So that gives me a value here, Virginica p-value. And I probably spelled it wrong, but we're going to roll with it. Okay, so now what I've done is I've gone from my linear model to pulling out an actual value. So now, in my text, I can start to do something very powerful. I can say, let's start a new paragraph. When we investigated, typing and talking at the same time is tough. When we investigated the linear model, the p-value was, now I could type in 2.62 0789 e to the negative 76, right? I could type that. I could also make a mistake while typing that. It's very easy to do. It's a very long number. It's very small. I could have said to e to the negative 75. Now that is an error. I've now messed up. So let's not do that. So let's add inline code. And the way we're going to do that is by using a single accent mark, right? So it's the tilde button, but it's without holding shift. So it's right above the tab key. I'm going to use R. So it's very similar to when you open a chunk. So I now have one accent mark and R. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to put in the name of the object that I just made. Virginica p-value. And then I'm going to close it with another accent mark. So now the code turns blue, or it may turn a different color if you have a different color scheme to your RStudio. Now that signifies that this piece of text is inline code. So if I now knit this, what I should get is when we investigated the linear model, the p-value was, and then it should give me the p-value. So let's knit it and see what happens. Now, since this p-value is so small, it may just give us the p-value was 0. So we'll see. As it comes, the moment of truth. Not yet. There it is. Okay. Now you can see this is what our paper looks like now that I've added all that lorem ipsum text. So we have our abstract, we have the introduction, methods, participants, data analysis. Now where we put this was after the first paragraph of discussion. So let's go look there. Here it is. Let's make this bigger and zoom in. It's very bright. When we investigated the linear model, the p-value was 0.00. So as you can see, maybe if I zoom in, I have this sentence here. When we investigated the linear model, the p-value was 0.00. That 0.00 is being pulled from the inline text. When we investigated the linear model, the p-value was accent R space Virginica underscore p-value accent period. So now, when we've knit this file, we've run the linear model, we've assigned an object to the value of output $p(3). We've assigned it to Virginica underscore p-value. And now we've called that inline in our text. And we can do that for anything, right? So let's say we want to do it for glance. Let's say we want to say what the R squared is. So what we can do is assign this. We can say glance output. Okay, here, so now we have glance output. Cool. So we have one, just value. So what we can do is say, we can say R squared is glance output $ R squared. And I want the first value of that because there's only one, right? So the one row is value, and that gives us the value of R squared. We can come in here and say, and the R squared was, add more inline code. Okay, so now we've now we're calling this other object R squared, which we just made. And when we knit that, everything that's going on here, the reason why it takes so long to get a file is because it's running all of those analyses at the moment. So if you then give this file to someone else, they're not looking at some frozen version of the file. They are running the file, all the analyses, for the first time for them as you've coded them. So now when we see here, when we investigated the linear model, the p-value was 0.00 and the R squared was 0.90. So we never even saw the R squared, right? We just went from glance to making an output data frame. We assigned R squared from that data frame and then we put it into the text. And there it is. So now this is the building block that you will then use to now write your paper using numerical values coming from the summaries of your statistical tests, and not you creating a bunch of outputs and then typing them out manually in a manuscript. So this is the first step, and it's a really exciting step. I'm going to put stars all over this video because this is kind of the one where you start to see the trees within the forest, or the forest from the trees, whatever that saying is. You're starting to see the big picture, the forest, I guess. That this is how you're going to build your paper. You're going to download all the files. You're going to get comfortable making graphs and tables. We didn't do tables yet, but making graphs. You can now do some statistical tests, and now you can generate those numbers in your text. So I hope you found that very useful. I find this very exciting. I hope you can tell. If you like these videos and you want to be notified for more, make sure you like and you favorite and you subscribe and you hit the bell. Follow me on Twitter so I can bother you on Twitter at NickFoxStats. And be sure to tune in for the next one. We're going to talk about common errors that you can get when doing your work in R. So until next time.